Congress League in 1978 and has got the generally used dedicated hot times of the 70s to Bessie Torola and Richard Truman of the University of Papua New Guinea and John Tanganaga and Eva Turner.
Thank you. exactly over a month.
And that's the unique style of the singers and the material that was coming out of Memphis in the mid-60s. There was a magic quality, a strong, open lifestyle that Dan Phillips managed to draw a picture of Dr. Phillips recalled. The music that came out of Walsh Castle, all the people that came out of Memphis, Tennessee, they all had a common background. They came out of the background. Elvis Presley was no different than B.B. King. B.B. King was black, and Elvis Presley was white, but they both had this natural spontaneous being raised in the South, not being exposed to mass media situations through radio, this wasn't still in this now. I've been hearing the wind blow and being able to see the wagon wheels going across flat roads and things like that. In my view, they affect the music and they affect the feel and the sensitivity of closeness to life. And that's transferred into the music, and they use their music to transcend their low economic lifestyle. And I have that
and he made millions of people happy.
All which is not to be denied.
And on January the 28th, 1956, Elvis Presley made his first network TV appearance on the Jimmy and Tommy Dorsey show. The world would never be the same. But as Scotty Moore remembers, despite all the nerves, Elvis and his friends were going to do their thing their way, the way they wanted to do it. Sure, it was an era of mixed tension that hung over that New York studio in January of 56.
Yes, sir, apprehension and deafness and tension, but they knew it was 56 in their show. At that time, we heard he was coming out.
Thank you.